Hello Abacus Weaver, welcome to Abacus Acumen for quick and sound learning. Today we are going to touch base with very important session, again a couple temperature displacement analysis using Abacus Explicit. So right now on my screen what you see is a disc brake. So it's a two-wheeler disc brake we have model, and if you closely look at it, it start rotating. And then there is a friction pad which comes and break it, and because of friction pad and the disc friction there is a heat generation. So if I take in one particular view, let me put in one particular view. So now you see, so there is a disc which start rotating, then there is a friction pad, you put a brake which come in a friction pad, stop the disc from rotating. And because of friction between the pad and the disc, it creates the heat generation. And we are trying to solve this problem. Also, we are looking at the stress level and we are looking into what is the temperature. So because of that, whatever the heat generated, that is we have modeled. So you see, temperature is initially at room temperature. And then as because of friction, heat is generated, very localized. Because of application of brake, disc come at a rest around 40 milliseconds, and then you see there is a lot of heat generation. So this is exactly problem we are going to do. Before solving this problem, we strongly recommend you to go through our one more video, Abacus Explicit, heat generation due to contact friction. Now this explain how you can model a heat generation due to friction between the two contacting body. So if you can go through this, recommend you to go through this, it will be easy for you to solve this. Even though you don't go through that, you can learn a lot of things from this, but strongly recommended if you can go through this. So this is the problem we are going to model. So let's go to the drawing board. So the today's topic we are touch base with again coupled temperature displacement analysis, but this we are going to solve with a dynamic explicit. So this will be like using dynamic explicit we are going to solve it. The problem we have taken is a spelling mistake, disc brake modeling. Now the disc which is rotating with a 100 rpm radians per second, and then we put a sudden brake, and we will see how the localized temperature distribution in the disc because of friction. That is what the study we are going to do. Again, spelling mistake. So you can have a disc with a steel, aluminium or any other things, but we have taken a two-wheeler disc. The motor property which we have taken is aluminium. Now if you have a right metal property for friction pad, you can use that, but the overall the study is how you can model something like a couple temperature displacement and modeling a disc brake. That's what actually we are decided to do. So we are started using all aluminium properties. So the units which we are use is a ton, newton, millimeter second. Both disc and pad is actually modeled with aluminium, and actual case there is a lot of holes and everything, but we are make a simplified model. So this disc is rotating with 100 radians per second. That is what actually it mentioned here. All temperature is initial temperature is 20 degrees C. There is a friction pad, so there is a pressure applied over a period of time on this to bring the disc top. That is what we applied the 5 MPa pressure, and then because of friction the heat is generated. Now to model the heat generated due to friction, we have to use star gap heat generation. So along with friction property, so there is a very high friction between friction pad and disc, which is a 0.5, and then you define how the heat is generated from this, whether all the friction is getting generated due to heat. That is what actually this number represent, and how much is the heat distribution on the master and slave surface. That is what exactly shown by the second number. So this is what exactly we'll do modeling. So few things is, we have taken a rectangular disc brake, but you can have a curve on everything. Those fancy things within geometry you can do it, but the main intention for this video is to understand how something can a disc brake model, and how we can study a stress and temperature within the structure. So that's where actually we decided to do a coupled temperature displacement. So disk is diameter is 120 millimeter. Overall thickness is 5 millimeter. This disk is 2.5 millimeter thick and then 10 by 15 millimeter width. And as you see, the friction pad is from the both sides. So the friction pad, there are two friction pads, so from both sides it comes. So we can also model this problem as a symmetry about y-axis. So that is exactly what we are going to do. So we are going to model this problem as a symmetry about y-axis. So let's quickly start doing modeling of this problem. So let's me put it new. So first first things we'll do is just give me 2 minutes time. We'll create first a pad. Not pad, we'll first create a disk. Just a minute. So disk, we are going to using solid extrusion, that is exactly what we'll use. So let me put something like 0,0 for a reference, and I can just put a circle. I can quickly give dimension here. So this is my 60 radius. So that's where actually I created the disk. I'm going to model a half symmetry about y. So I'm going to model only disk with a 2.5 millimeter thick. So I just model a disk with 2.5 millimeter. I'm also do one thing. I'm going to put a reference point as a 0,0, just a single point. I'll get back to you why this point I put, because I just want to know which is a symmetry plane. When you model a disk, you'll not able to find which is a symmetry plane. So I know the axis where this reference point is there, that is my symmetry point. Now quickly I put YZ as one plane because I want to cut it, and then XZ also I'll put one plane, and then because I want to cut this, so that way I can have on central a number of nodes, I'm going to put some boundary condition there. So let's quickly cut it. So I'm going to cut the sail using datum plane. So I selected the datum plane and then I'll say done. So I done it. So this is where exactly gonna create partition sail. Then I selected the cell and then selected the datum line and I created that. So that's where we have done. We cut the disk. Quickly create matter property. It is aluminium. Density is required because MCP delta T 2.7 e power minus 9. I'll have a mechanical property which is a 70 e power 3, 0.3 as a Poisson's ratio, and then I'll have conductivity which is 0.15, and then specific heat which is a 670123. So I done that. So just quickly go back. So this is what property I put. 70 e power 03 MPa modulus, 0.15 watt per millimeter degree Celsius conductivity, specific heat which I put joule per ton per degree Celsius, 670 and 000. So we will assign this. This is disk, and then I quickly assign this. So it changes the color. So I quickly done this. Now I'll create pad. Now pad, I'll put 0,0, then I'll put 40,0 and 50,0. So that way I got a 2 point, and then I can just, so this is a 10 and this is a 15. You can measure it. This is 15 and this is 10. So and then done. I put this. This is actually 5 millimeter. They are thick. So I put a 5 millimeter then I can quickly define this is pad, and then I can assign the property to this pad. So that way we created both everything. Now quickly we'll do assembly. So let me now move this by, first move by 2.5 millimeters. So I move this by 0, 0, 2.5, so that comes on a surface, but I just want to keep a gap. It is not exactly touching it, it have some gap, so let's model that gap. So this is 0, 0, 1, so that way there is a gap. So if you looked into some view, you'll find it, there is a gap. So we are going to model a half section. So that's where we are done assembly, done positioning. Let's create a step. Step will be, this is like this is exactly what we are going to do. Dynamic temperature displacement explicit. It is, we are going to run for 40 milliseconds and it'll jump on. Let's go to the interaction. Now this is important step. So when you create a friction, there is a high friction between the normal behavior, and then you put a tangential behavior, penalty based friction. So friction is 0.5, which is on higher side. One is a sticky surface, there is a high friction between the pad and the disc. The pad have different material, but for simplicity we put aluminium, but exactly the pad have a more frictious surface which take high heat and everything. So that's we have put. Now how we are going to model a heat, then you go to thermal and you say heat generation, and we are going to use a default property. Default property, what it say? It say fraction of dissipated energy caused by friction converted into heat 1, and then friction of converted heat to the slave surface 50-50% distribution. That's what actually it mentioned. Now we'll quickly create the contact. It will be surface to surface explicit contact. So I required the first master surface. Now master surface is inside that, so let me first hide the disc. So this is how I select my master surface. Now my slave surface is on disc, so let's put disc on. And this is my surface, second I select this and this. So I selected that already motor friction property was connected. Now let's start putting the load. So number one, first let's put a pressure of 5 MPa on this. So this is a surface which will have a 5 MPa pressure, not instantaneously, it will have a amplitude. At time is equal to 0, amplitude is 0, and time is equal to 0.04, amplitude is 1. So this is a friction done on that. I need to put some boundary condition. So boundary condition create, one is a Z symmetry. Because this is the two friction pad come and the select. So this is a Z symmetry, and this is my whole surface which will have Z symmetry. So I define a Z symmetry there. Then my pad will have X, Y. So my whole pad cannot move in XY. It can only move in Z direction. That is what exactly I defined. So it can only move in this direction, not other. So that's where I put. Now I want to put some boundary condition in center, but for that I required a center nodes. Not, I cannot put here. Now we'll come back to this, but before that we'll quickly mesh it. So select a right element for this. The right element is for from explicit library coupled temperature displacement C3DAT. That is what exactly is the right element. We take a hex and let's mesh it. So let's put a mesh. So this is the mesh for pad is done, and then similarly we'll select a right element explicit and then we mesh it. So that's where we completed the meshing. Now number one thing, I need to create some sets for meshing assembly. I want to first create the some node set. So number one, all nodes, because we are going to have initial temperature on the all node as a room temperature. So let me first select all, and so that created the all node. And then I want in a center, I want to create a center node set to create a boundary condition. So center all nodes I click selected, that is for boundary condition. So I go to load and then I put center end caster condition. So center node is constant in all direction, that gives the stability to model. So this is center node end caster condition. Now we'll quickly define something like a predefined condition. There are two predefined condition. One is giving temperature. So all nodes is at room temperature, so we are going to put a 20 degree C, that what we are put. And then one more predefined condition is velocity. Now velocity will be only on the disk break, which is only rotational velocity. Rotational velocity of 100 radians per second, but about what axis? So we are going to give a 100 radians per second about a z-axis. So how you can define a z-axis? So you define the first point, and and then you define the another point. So you between the axis 1 and point and axis 2, you are defined, actually it is nothing but a z-axis. So 0 0 to going to the 0 0 1, which is nothing but a z-axis. So it's going to apply the rotational velocity about the z-axis. So that exactly we have put. Now loads, let me check everything. We put center pad, we put a z constant, we define a predefined condition, we also given a load. I think we are ready to go. So let's create a job disk break. Let's do a data check. If there is some issue with data check, we'll just check for a data check, otherwise it's just ready to go. So it's completed. Let me save this is not a right directory, this is disk break. So let me put here disk break. Let's submit it and then we'll just wait for results, how the results looks like, and then we can check it. I'll also show you when you looked into results how you can mirror this axis symmetry problem into full problem. So if we can mirror this about this point, you can see the two disc brake coming and putting a friction there. So we'll see that once results are out. So let's quickly see where it has gone. It has gone till 160 milliseconds. So we'll see how the results looks like. So you first go and say select the field output. nodal temperature, and then once you put it, so it's putting a break. Now how we have to really replicate it so that you can get full model, that I'll show. So you go to visualization ODB display option, you go to mirror pattern, and here it is mirror about XY plane. So you put that way, you see there is a full model is coming. So you see now it put a break, so it is now there is a gap of 1 millimeter, then it's putting break and then it is generating. So the still run is going on, it's almost bring the disk at stop, it created the heat. You can also take a Y plane to see how it looks. You can also check how heat is generated, how the heat is getting transferred from the break to this. So you see now, let's wait, it put and then there is a heat generation. So there is a friction based heat generated and then heat get transferred locally. So this is what exactly problem we going to do. I hope you like this video. Don't forget to like us and subscribe us. And then if you have anything query or anything, just write it to abacusacumen@gmail.com. Also, don't forget to share this video with your friends who are in the need to learn the Abacus. The Abacus Acumen whole motivation to do this video is to give a quality Abacus simulation knowledge at free cost. So please share this video with your friends and who are in the need of Abacus learning. Thank you. Bye-bye.